So my experience in the toy store I worked in for a while, they told us, and this is the big shame of retail, they told us that once the customer makes enough noise, shut them up by giving them a refund. And that's really bad as a precedent, because it just encourages people to be fucking loud. Oh, fucking hell, they can do whatever they want. I don't work in retail anymore, but please, for the God, remember that there are people that work behind those registers, people. Okay? They could be you. I actually recommend everyone work in a tough retail job before doing anything in life, just so you can be humbled by the fact that it's fucking horrible to work in a really rough retail job.
Yeah, retail can be rough. Service industries can, they have their moments.
I used to,
I worked in retail for 3 hours, does that count?
I used to, when I used to run the Twitch stream before I did any YouTube reviews, and there used to be a meme on my stream that whenever I ran it, because it used to be between 1 and 4 hours for every other day, and so my fans would be like, have you got any more work stories? I used to have loads of work stories. I have a favorite that I feel like I should probably not tell, because we've got loads of super chats right now, but I mean, we're pretty long on EFAP, right? So it wouldn't matter,
long
really.
Long man, bad.
I'm curious now.
So, you guys know, what are they called?
Fuck, wrap it up already, get to the point.
The Funko Pop dolls, right?
Yes, I do,
so
yeah.
We had I was in charge of the software department, and for some fucking reason, they gave us the Funko Pops, because I guess they're connected to media, and software is typically a lot of media. So we had to take charge of them. We had this huge stand of them, and we also had a security guard, because every store should have a security guard, that makes sense. We actually got him installed, because someone tried to run away with a PS4, and our manager had to tackle them. It was the most fucking hilarious thing you've ever seen. We got a security guard. And so this couple came up to my till, because I was in charge of software. I had only been working there for 3 months, and I was put in charge.
So you're in charge of like the software department.
Yeah, which is the most like.
Okay.
It was ridiculous. It was a really, 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 really bad situation. I try to be vague about it because I don't want to put anyone in trouble, but it was terrible. I shouldn't have been in charge, but I was the best person to be put in charge because of how bad the turnover was there. So I was just doing my dailies, and then I saw this couple come up to the stand with all the Funko Pops, and they just start taking them all out onto the floor, and like the entire stand. And I was just looking at them like, okay, that's odd behavior. The idea, I'm talking like 100 of Funko Pops, they're just putting them all on the floor. And the security guard looks at them, and he looks at me, and he looks back at them, and he's just like, you know, like mouths, what the fuck are they doing? And I just shrug my shoulders like, I don't know. And they're just staring at them, and they're looking back, looking through them all. And he walks up to them, and he's like, what are you doing? And, like, I'm in range, so I can hear the conversation. And then they're like, oh, we're just looking through them, because we're just looking for the ones we want. And he was like, okay, people walk through here. So if you wouldn't mind, like, you know, doing this in a more efficient manner, if you have to do this way. Whatever, you know, it's sort of thing. And they put them all back. But then, like, the woman out of it's a guy and a girl. The woman's, like, distressed about this. I remember finding it odd, but I just go back to my work, whatever. And then fast forward about 20 minutes, and my manager comes up to me, and she was like, I need to speak to you about our security guard. And I was like, okay. And the couple and my manager come up to me, and they're like, so these people feel very distressed. Were they harassed by the security guard? And I was like, and they were like, you were there. You heard what he said. And I was like, so, You guys were looking at the Funko Pops, right? And they're like, yeah, do you remember what he said? Like, oh, well, he said that he wanted to know what you were doing, right? And they were like, no. I was like, oh, sorry, what did he say? And they were like, he was like, are you trying to rob the store? Are you trying to sneakily put these into your clothing? And he was like, oh, I need to check what you're doing. I was like, oh, I don't remember him saying that. And then, like, they started talking more, and then I got, the manager talked to me separately, and she was like, I think these people are crazy? Like, what actually happened? And I was like, he literally just asked what they were doing, and that was it. And she was like, yeah, that's what the security guard told me. And then they came over as we were talking, they were like, I demand he be fired. I demand he be fired. And we were both, like, wide-eyed, like, I don't think that's how it works. Like, I don't think you can just fire somebody.
The customer does not have the power to hire and fire, actually.
And ironically, she was like, we will never shop here again unless he's fired. And my manager was like, okay.
That seems like a win-win, right?
And Yeah, well, they left outraged. The security guard was like, "Hey man, thanks for backing me up." And I was like, "What do you mean? And my manager was like, "Yeah, if ever this shit happens, just fucking hell, these people need a reality check. Like, some customers are actually insane, and they just do not listen to what people are actually saying, and they just imagine slights so they can get free shit. Or they can demand people get fired. It's the most insane." And this is one of like 1,000 stories. Retail is hell when you live in like you're working some of the worst jobs. And I had like, it was a nightmare. And like, I remember just being like, what the fuck? I need. And she was like, if you had told me that he had abused them, he may have lost his job. But I was just like, how arbitrary your life can be when you're in retail, that a fucking annoying customer can cost you everything just because they didn't listen to what you were actually saying.
Yeah, generally when it comes to stuff like that, jobs will put people on like a warning system, or they have like verbal warnings and written warnings and then temporary suspensions. Before I did the internet stuff, I worked in a hotel. And while I was in that hotel, I did valet, I did concierge, I did bellhop essentially. I worked in the restaurant. I worked in the banquets department. We did all kinds of stuff. We did. So I know all about how crazy people can be when you work all around a hotel and you see people coming in and out and in and out and out every single day. Hundreds of people every day. And everyone's got, you know, most people you never remember because they're just in and out. They just want to get along with their lives. And every once in a while, you see enough people that if, you know, 0.5% of people are fucking psychos.
Yeah.
You're going to eventually run into a bunch of psychos.
It was eye-opening, and this is why I recommend everyone have that experience, because, like I said, so many stories. This one's quicker, but we had a special when Pokemon X and Y released, and they were like, you can, we give them out a card that has a code on it, and it'll give you a free Pokemon when you put it into your whatever fucking console you have. And, like, we ran out, because the idea was you give it one card with every purchase of the game, and eventually we ran out, as any store does. And a guy walked up to me, he looked like he was in his 60s, but he had the outfit of, like, someone who was, like, fucking 10 years old. He had, like, shorts and a nice, like, little shirt, and he was holding his games, and he was like, the sign said that you get a free Pokemon code, I'd like to have that. I was like, yeah, sorry, no, we were out, the promotion hasn't been refilled on our side, so I can't give you that. And he was like, okay, I can wait. And he just stood there, and I was like, no, I mean like deliveries, like this could be a week, it could be more, like I don't know, because I just work here, I don't know what the actual deliveries are, but yeah, we used to have, you know, we had a whole stack, but we've given them out with every game purchase, and we've ran out now. And he was like, well, that's unacceptable. And you just awkwardly stand there, and he's like, I'd like to speak to a manager. And I'm like, the manager will tell you the exact same, and he's like, I'd like to speak to a manager. And there's, you hear about these stories as like almost jokes in movies and stuff, but these things happen. People are insane.
There are people like that.
And the manager comes down and tells you the exact same fucking thing because they don't know anything about it, so they ask me about it, and I tell them what I told them, and they tell them the fucking customer, and the customer's like, that's unacceptable. And they're like, okay, do you want to see my manager? It's like, do you want to see the fucking co-owner of the store?
How far up the chain? You want to talk to the CEO? Is that what you want?
And you just
you want us to fly you out to London to go to corporate headquarters to get into a business meeting room with our CEO so we can explain to you that things are limited in this finite world.
That's not acceptable. You're free not to accept it just as long as you don't accept it somewhere else that's not here.
And you'll find like the same guy comes back the following day, like, have you got them now? It's like I said, like it could be like Jesus Christ. You don't want to live anymore? And it was, yeah, nightmare. I didn't leave that job because I found a better one. I left it out of pure stress. It was a nightmare. In the purest sense, it was the fucking worst job I've ever had. And there's more stories to come, but I don't want to delay this too quickly. It's just that delay this more morally. Words fail me. It's a bad thing. And if everyone goes to retail and experiences it, it'll make you a lot more humble about people in retail. The best story I have, and again, I'll try and make this as quickly as possible, is that we have tents. So think of them as several outdoor tent things. And this is before software. I was in control of outdoors first, which is just, imagine everything you'd have outdoors. You'd have like the 4-foot tent, then the 6-foot tent, and then the 12-foot tent, which not many people buy. But this guy wanted a 12-foot tent. I was like, okay, I'll go find one for you. It took me like 10 minutes in the back, but I found a 12-foot tent, and then by the time I was getting it out for him, I realized that the box was all damaged, and I was like, fuck, I can't sell this to a customer, because this is just bad. And then after another 10 minutes, I found a 12-foot tent, and the box looked fine, and I checked it, and it was like, it was missing one of the most important poles, and I was like, this can't work either. Then I woke up to my till to check the stock, see if there's more than two. He was like, is everything okay? And I was like, there are two in stock, they're not sellable. I was like, and I think I said something like they're reserved to try and cover it instead of saying they're just broken because it makes the store look terrible. So I was like,
yeah,
so I'm trying to find you a different one. He's like, yeah, okay, fine. And so I look for ages, and then it says there's one in like warehouse B. I go over there, and then I find out after searching for ages from the guy who works the warehouse, is like, oh no, we sold that one, we haven't recorded it yet. And I was like, oh, okay. And, you know, after like a good half hour, 40 minutes, I remember coming back to this guy with the unfortunate information that he's just wasted his time standing here and we don't have it, and he's going to have to wait X amount of time, we'll go to a different store. His reaction? Okay. Thank you for looking. And he left. I was just like, wow.
Some people are...
Thank you so fucking much.
Yeah, some people are, you know, nothing I can do about it.
And it's the idea that
I can't magically make things appear.
The fundamental thing you have to appreciate in retail, and this isn't 100% true, but most of the time, I don't want to waste your time. I want you to get out, and that's not supposed to be rude. It's me telling you that I'm trying to get the job done as quickly as possible so I can get back to all the standard jobs that I have in the day, regardless of customers, which is typically a lot. Customers are usually on top of whatever jobs you have to do in the day. So when a customer's like, I want X, you get it to them as soon as possible so you can get back on with your job. So the idea that it's like, you've been fucking me over, it's like, no. Trust me, workers want you to go satisfied as soon as possible. So try not to demonize them, that's all. Like, and yeah, I really appreciate that guy. That guy was like my favorite customer ever. And all he did was say, okay.
Some people are super chill, some people are super anal about everything.
Typically, and this is the thing, it's not to say that everyone in retail is working their ass off for you. Some people are assholes, some workers don't give a shit, so... But it's just try and stay calm, because my god, I have some stories about the most assholic fucking customers in history. And you know the meme about how it's like a 40-year-old woman with that standard hairstyle? It's like, yeah, there was a lot of those.
Yeah.
It's more than just a meme, I swear. But, yeah. Anyway, moving on.